Get ready to match the stars from The Love Boat. Bernie Coppell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly. From Entertainment Tonight, Marjorie Wallace, Scully Mitchell. And from Harper Valley, PTA Edie McClure. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
I have to spray my shoes because my shoes build up static electricity, and it makes this microphone make snap, crackle, pop noises.
Oh, that's shocking.
Ready? One, two, three. Thank you very much.
How you been, Ben?
Oxygen.
Like that?
Oxygen.
All right.
You're very moved today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, I love this outfit. This is a brand new jacket.
You're the sharpest host on television.
Am I the best dressed man on television?
No, you're the sharpest host. Yeah, well, you went on a little bigger spectrum now.
You get an answer, take a mile.
All right. Who dresses better than I do in all of television?
In all of television?
Who? Name one. Charles Nelson Reilly?
Alistair Cook.
Alistair Cook. He wears that same crummy blue blazer year in and year out.
Than you, huh?
Thanks a lot.
You're the best.
All right, that's all I want to hear. Hello, Kathy Walker and Roy Wynn. Yeah. Applause, applause, applause. You remember Roy Wynn? He's married. He's got two kids. His wife is here. His kids are 3 years and 6 years of age, and they're at home.
Watching television.
Right. And where are you from again, Roy? You're originally
Miami, Florida.
Miami, and you moved here to California, and you like it.
Yes.
All right. And Kathy Walker, give us a salient facts about your life once again, please.
I sell data processing equipment and services.
What does that mean?
That means computers. Sell computers to small businesses.
Yeah. How big are your computers? This big?
Hey.
Well, we have.
Don't get personal.
No. No, that's
we have some that big and larger, and we also have a time sharing system. So that means you get the small one, and you get to use the big one.
Oh.
Yeah.
That sounds interesting to me.
I'll take it.
Should we buy some, folks?
I would, in a minute.
All right. Here we go. Where are we? This is the second round of the final game, right? And 4-2 is a score. So, Roy, you're ahead. That means you have to go first.
Hey.
Hey, it is. Two people play. Marjorie and Scoey.
Yes, sir.
Weird Willie is so weird.
How weird is he?
He's the only man in the world who likes to blank in quicksand. All right, here we go, Roy. Weird Willie is...
Oh. You don't play.
Oh, God.
Her mind hasn't worked for 3 years. Weird Willie is so weird, he's the only man in the world who likes to blank in quicksand.
Swim.
Swim. What do you say, Marjorie? He said swim.
Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy was...
Oh, sorry.
Marjorie has a small child.
I was putting myself to sleep.
And all of those little nursery rhymes.
This guy likes to make love in quicksand.
Uh-huh.
Don't ask me how. I don't understand it myself.
Really?
That's what he told me.
A little kinky, isn't it?
Yeah. You said he was weird.
All right. I said it. Okay. What do you say, Scoey?
Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear.
You're on. You.
Oh, I was just thinking about making love in quicksand. Jeez, that sounds great. I said swim.
Swim. There's one for him. Now, Kathy, he has five, you have two. That means you need three to tie and four to win.
Okay.
This is it. Fred said, that boxer is really short. Your heart's not in it. The boxer's really short. The only way he's going to win is if the other guy has a glass blank. Short.
Has a real beat, doesn't it?
All right, Kathy. Fred said that boxer is really short. The only way he's going to win is if the other guy has a glass blank.
A glass knee?
Knee. Yeah. She said a glass knee. What do you think of that, Chuck? She said a glass knee.
I didn't understand him. Forgive me. I said knee.
Ah.
Is that acting? You don't see acting like that every day.
No.
That is acting.
Indicating.
Bad acting, but acting all the same.
You were indicating, Charles. Marjorie, the only way he's going to win if the other guy has a glass...
Knee.
Knee. Tied before the score. What do you say?
I say the fact that she might tie is better than losing.
Right.
You tie it anyhow, baby. Knee.
Knee. Now, it's all up to you, Edie McClure.
Oh, well, I'm so short anyway. I have often looked, you know, at people's belt buckles and thought that this was normal.
Right.
And so I worked it around to another part of the body. It's kind of knobby looking, but it is a knee.
Uh-huh.
You did it.
Now, Roy, we've got some prizes for you. We're going to see that you get a spanking from Burt Reynolds. I'm going to send you a big ball of lint. You'll find all kinds of wonderful uses for that. Many thanks for... Listen, I'm not through talking to you. What the hell? What is that? Remember Roy? He was standing right there a second ago. Roy. What happened to you? Roy? Roy, are you in there? I don't know where he is. Well, we'll look for him while you watch this. Kathy, I just want to make you feel good. Last time you blew it, right?
That's what I had in mind.
Likely story.
No, you're not going to do that this time, are you?
No.
No, you're going to think very carefully before you respond. All right, good luck to you.
Oh, she did okay last
time. She did okay.
Yes, sir.
Who blew it last
time? Nobody blew it. It was one of those wide-open questions where there was 20 answers to it.
Oh, thank you for clarifying that, Scoey.
You're right, Scoey. You're right.
Terrible question.
We polled the studio audience, said write down your best answer to this. Prove blank. Prove blank. All right, look them over. The bright eyes over there has an answer.
Edie.
Prove it.
Prove it. All right, there's one.
Scully.
Is this it? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought she was saying yes. Prove me wrong.
Prove me wrong. All right, that's his.
Marjorie?
Prove yourself.
Prove yourself. Third is tough, isn't it?
Yes.
So those are the three. Prove yourself, prove me wrong, and prove it. You want one of those or one of your own?
I like prove it.
You do like prove it.
Mm-hmm.
Things are going to be up there.
Going to be up there.
Not down at the bottom.
Going
to be at the top. She says it's going to be at the top. Let's start at the bottom and see what's there. Prove me wrong. There's Scoey's answer. All
Ooh,
right.
You're right.
Now, the next one says, prove yourself.
Nah, 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 nah.
It's all right, baby.
Yeah, all right.
She wants.
Bigger than mine.
Last chance for prove it. Here we go. Yeah. Bravo, bravo.
Go ahead.
Get the money, baby.
No, all right, you want to spin the wheel? Why not? Cigar. Okay. What do you want to do now?
Win some more money.
Oh, all right.
Atta girl.
Prove it.
I can't help you. I can't help you. All right, here's the question. Face my body. Thank you. Now put your arms around me. No. Here.
Now that's easy money.
You ready, Miss Edie?
Oh, I'm so ready. I'm so... yes.
Edie's nervous, but
you're
not, are you?
Yes, I am. It's a lot of dough.
You're cool, aren't you? Yeah. Meet your blank. Meet your blank. All right, your job is to match her. How do you fill in that blank to match her?
Meet your maker.
Meet your maker. She says, make your, meet your, meet, meet, she said.
Been
she
doing
said
this long?
Yes.
That's what she's gonna do after she shows this answer.
Meet Your Maker.
Well.
Hey, that'd be a name of a great new TV show. Meet Your. No, I guess it
you
wouldn't.
You could only guest star on it once, though.
That's right. After that.
Oh, it's for geriatrics, and I say, Meet My Maker.
Aha! $600, and we're very happy for you. Congratulations to you, Kathy. Thank you for being with us. All right. Now here comes Petty Officer Carol Waiter and Charlie Brown. Hey! Welcome, welcome. Let's get acquainted first with Carol Waiter. You're a petty officer, eh?
Yes.
Where do you do that? Where do you pet?
Really, any way they'll let me.
All right.
I'm an air traffic controller in the United States Navy, and I air traffic control the South Pole for 6 months out of the year, and I spend 6 months in California.
What a fascinating job.
Kind of.
Yeah. It's a nerve-wracking job, isn't it? Of course, you don't have much traffic down there, do you?
Yeah, we do. Surprisingly, what? We have a lot. We have
really?
Our own squadron that supports all the outlying
stations.
That's right.
They had three planes last year.
We have a full squadron based there, huh?
Yes.
I see.
South Pole.
How high is your tower? I want to know how high this girl gets.
I think that's a personal question.
Oh. All right. Now, you're on... You're on furlough or leave or something now?
No, I'm on a day off.
A day off? I mean, you're going back to the South Pole tonight?
No, I'm on... I deploy annually. And now I'm just...
Don't we all? Don't you deploy annually? I try to, at least once a year. All right. Carol, good luck to you. I suppose you've gotten a lot of flack through the years about your name, so I'm not going to open my mouth about it. Just welcome you, Charlie Brown. Nice to have you here.
What a guy.
That's his name.
Yeah.
Nobody over here is going to do anything about Snoopy or any
Linus.
Of that stuff. We're not going to do that about
very
sleeping
pleasant.
On top of the doghouse or any of that. We're not going to do any of that, right?
Right.
We're not. The first thing you have to learn in show business, do not do the obvious joke. And if you talk about his name being Charlie Brown and all that stuff, that's a very obvious joke. You want to do a commercial here? No. Oh, talk to him, yes. No, we got to find out where you're from,
Charlie. Somebody
Charlie.
New on those.
San Francisco, California.
San Francisco.
Right.
And what do you do for a living, if anything?
If anything is a good category, I'm a saloon keeper.
A saloon keeper?
Right.
Really?
That's
mm-hmm.
A mixologist, if you like. A mixologist, if
a
you
mixologist.
Like.
A mixologist.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you own the establishment?
So far.
Really?
Yeah. But I've been away for 24 hours.
Yeah. Yeah, they can really steal in that business, can't they?
I'm going to feel bad.
Well, you better win here.
Yeah.
I mean, if they're watching, they'll be gone. They'll take the glassware and everything before you get back.
Maybe we should hurry.
Do you drink?
Oh, yes.
You do?
Right. Yeah.
I would tell you, either that or you did a little red makeup in your eyes there. I wasn't sure there.
I have to sample the product occasionally.
Right. You got to test it, make sure it's quality stuff there.
We have rules.
Rules. Okay, good luck to Charlie Brown and to Carol Waiter. We'll start this game in a moment. Now this for you. Now, we're about ready to begin, but Stars, if you want to take a look at that monitor, would you step out of the way there? Because I want to get a tight shot of Carol's right arm, if I can. Just leave it where it is there. Can you see that monitor? Yeah. That is a tattoo on her arm, and I asked her about that. She says, well, I am a sailor. It's a mushroom, is it?
Yeah.
A good luck symbol?
Yeah. Maybe, sure.
Yeah. What months of the year are you in?
From October until March. It's the austral summer. It's summer down there.
Is it summer down there, October through March?
Sure.
And what kind of weather do you get? What temperatures?
Well, when we step off the plane in October, with the wind chill, it's about 150 below.
That's your summer?
Below
that's
what?
Summer.
Yeah.
Below zero.
Below the equator.
That's true.
That is mighty, mighty cold. You have to wear masks, do you?
We get issued a full set of cold weather gear. But then around December and January, it warms up, it gets above zero, and most of us are running around in T-shirts.
Really?
Yeah.
But it's not humid, is it?
No, it's very
it's a dry cold.
All right, Daryl, let's begin with you, A or B?
B, please.
A or B. Okay. Dan said, I just saw a sign that said, we fluff and fold. What's strange is, a sign was in a blank.
Did you go to Australia?
Yes, just got back.
Oh, my arm's tired.
Yeah. Australia was wonderful. The people are so sweet and generous.
How long are we down there?
About 6 weeks all
together. You did one show, one big two-hour number?
No, we did two-hour specials, and we went out on the Sea Princess for 2 weeks in the middle of the time we were there.
Yeah, you liked it.
Oh, people are amazing, and they love Americans.
They do?
Yes, Australians love Americans.
That's because they never see
We were colonized pretty much around the same time.
You were?
Yes, I got colonized in Sydney.
All right, Carol. Dan said, I just saw a sign that said, we fluff and fold. What's strange is, the sign was in a blank.
Locker room.
A locker room. Uh-huh.
It makes sense to me, David.
She's... Now, wait a minute. You know, you'd be down at South Pole so long, 150 degrees below zero, it does things to your head there. What do you say?
Well, I had that experience in Sydney, actually.
Really?
What? Yes.
You walked in a place that said we fluff and fold?
Massage parlor.
A massage parlor. Oh, Yolanda, if you could only hear this now.
Only kidding, honey.
All right.
It's true, he did have that experience.
He did?
And he was so disappointed, he cried all the way back to the hotel. Massage parlor.
Well, it's two of those. She was looking for a locker room.
I said a car wash.
A car wash. Very good.
Thank you, Uncle James.
Very good. Car wash. We're beginning to make a little sense. It's frightening, but that's the truth. What do you say? We fluff and fold.
Massage parlor.
A massage parlor. All right, Scoey.
I gave the definitive. Church.
A church. We fluff and fold.
Well, it's just a very poor attempt at being funny.
It's all right. I got it, and I loved it.
Well, I went for the low road in the massage parlor.
All right. So, Carol, now you know how to play the game.
My lady.
And you know what's on their minds. All right, Charlie. Horrible Hannah is so horrible. She uses blank as a breath freshener. Here we go. Horrible Hannah is so horrible, she uses blank as a breath freshener.
Garlic.
Garlic is a good response, I think.
Well,
little garlic.
Garlic.
Garlic is what he said.
Yeah, well, Horrible Hannah has a real breath problem, so she uses Drano.
Drano. Wow. That'll do it.
That's smart. Bandino.
Bandino.
Mix it with a little water and some club soda and gargle it away.
Right. What do you say, Chuck, baby?
Bandini.
I went another route altogether.
An altogether different route.
Garlic.
Garlic. They correct me, Ken. Yes. That's two today.
What acting?
Wonderful. Horrible Hannah. She uses blank as a breath freshener.
Bernie and I are on the same wavelength.
Comet. All right. So we have Drano, Comet, and one garlic, and what?
I said Drano.
Drano. That's two Dranos. One Comet. What do you say there,
Edie? Well, on another commercial route, Lysol, deep cleans for you.
Yeah, Lysol. So there we are at the end of round one. 1-0 in Charles' favor. And now this for you. Listen, you were all splendid.
Thank you.
But you'll be better tomorrow.
All right. You hope.
No. Any plugs or anybody that had anything to say there?
I'd like to apologize.
To whom?
To you.
Yes.
For Charles's behavior in diverting me into conversation.
All right.
When you were.
If it happens again, severe disciplinary action will be taken.
Gene, I'd like to get a plug in.
Yes.
At the end of this week, folks, I'd be out of work, so if anybody got a job for me, we...
You do Scoey Windows?
No, he doesn't do Windows. Scoey will be available.
For myself. Yes, I do Windows. Oh, I don't do them well. But.
Join us next time for the Match Game. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive a beautiful jewelry ensemble in the Golden Manor of Monet, designed and crafted by Monet, the master jeweler. And beautiful wall covering and easy-to-use squares. Dip them in water and put them up. DuPont Flair squares make decorating easy. And Baker's Secret from Echo, the silicone-coated nonstick bakeware, is the easy way to better baking. Makes clean-up easy as pie. And a tray, and why not switch to Listermint with its fresh, minty taste or zesty Listermint cinnamon. They taste as good as they work. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. The program was edited for broadcast.